mission we have undertaken, which we call in different names India 100 years and India 2047, and a mission for community empowerment. This mission is closely linked to the legacy of our independence. At the core of it, we have the very idea of India and India's independence in this mission. The concept of India 100 years and the destination India 2047, this idea was first discussed on another Independence Day 3 years back, on 15th August 2013, on the 66th Independence Day at Empower India Foundation. Now, and we have been traveling extensively throughout the length and breadth of India during the past 3 years, holding discussions with intellectuals, academics, social workers, and community leaders, and those activists who are working at the grassroots, and sharing our dreams, sharing our vision and mission, and getting inputs from a very wide strata of people throughout India. And alhamdulillah, praise be to God Almighty, by the grace of Almighty, now we are completing the first phase of this journey, the first phase of this long journey, which we have only started now. And that is the project document, which forms the basis of our mission. This project document will be released, and we will have a kickstart of its implementation from today.
एक document देखेंगे जिसका इजरा जनाब सच्चर साहब करने वाले हैं, जिसमें आने वाले 31 वर्षों के लिए प्रोग्राम बनाए गए हैं। ये सिर्फ डॉक्यूमेंट नहीं है, ये एक मिशन है, जिस मिशन की तकमील इंशाअल्लाह हम सब लोग एक दूसरे से मिलकर आने वाले वर्षों में करेंगे।
अगर 25-30 पीपल भी कंसिडर नेशनल लेवल, दैट इंक्लूडेड प्रोफेसर रमदान कुंडू, रिसेंटली वी मेट रजिंदर सचर सब आल्सो, एंड मेनी अदर पीपल लाइक दैट, about 3-4 members of Sachar committee, another 3-4 members of Kundu committee, eminent people from Jawaharlal Nehru University, Jamia Millia, Aligarh, and other universities also. And that was a very good experience, and it was very encouraging also, because we got excellent support.
क्योंकि मैंने इस रिपोर्ट को जब मुझे देखा था तो मैं महसूस कर रहा था बहुत देर से कि अपडेट रिपोर्ट को कैसे कुछ बनाएगा कि नहीं। उस लैब को आप लोगों ने इस रिपोर्ट में पूरा कर खुद ही को गर्वबुलंद इतना कि खुदा हर तकदीर से पहले बंदे से पूछे कि बता तेरी रजा क्या। मैं फिर आपको मौका देता हूँ और आपके सब उन कंट्रीब्यूटर्स को, आम मर्दों को और आप लोगों को जिन्होंने ये चीज बनाई है, एंड आई थिंक इस रिपोर्ट को लेके आगे के जो प्रोग्राम आप लोग बना रहे हैं वो जरूर बनाएंगे।
इंडिया 2047, बट आई कैन क्लियरली सी दैट द पर्सपेक्टिव इज वेरी डिफरेंट। वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट पार्टिसिपेशन, वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट इंक्लूसिवनेस, we're talking about employment and empowerment of the marginalized communities. Please accept my greetings on this great event when you're celebrating the 70th Independence Day with the perspective of making India's growth process more inclusive.
I greatly appreciate what they stated in the roadmap India 2047 document in the beginning itself. बहुत कम ऐसा पढ़ने को मिलता है, एंड इट कॉट माई अटेंशन। इट सेज लेट अस नॉट बी पेसिमिस्टिक हु सी ओनली डिफिकल्टीज इन अपॉर्चुनिटीज, लेट अस बी ऑप्टिमिस्टिक हु कैन टर्न एवरी डिफिकल्टी इनटू एन अपॉर्चुनिटी। दैट इज व्हाट इज नीडेड।
दिस नेशनल कॉन्क्लेव एंड द लॉन्चिंग ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट डॉक्यूमेंट ऑन दिस मोमेंटस ओकेशन ऑफ द सेलिब्रेशन ऑफ 70th Independence Day is indeed a dream come true. It is a long-term community development project that can truly benefit the people and the community at large.
I am very happy that this Empower India Foundation has brought out a beautiful report. It is going to be a framework of action. So since independence, I have never seen such a comprehensive initiative from the side of the Muslim community to do something at the grassroots level to transform the scenario. I congratulate the Empower India Foundation team members.
It is an honor for me to be present in this wonderful program, which will prove to be a major milestone in the history of our country. I would like to congratulate the team of India 2047, led by E.M. Abdul Rahman Sahab, for formulating a detailed roadmap for the empowerment of the country. I sincerely believe that this project is a great offering to the people of India. The depth of the study and interactions involved in preparing the roadmap itself is a motivating factor. This roadmap is a unique initiative and it deserves the complete support of the community.
Let me first confess, this is the first ever such a wonderful professionally managed and professional document. But now the responsibility of the organizers have increased.
Really, it is an awakening moment in the life of Muslims to receive such a document. This is the message for the Muslim community in India to take forward things, what we need to plan for another 50 years. I think this is the best message the Empower India has given to the people of India, in particular to the Muslims. As Professor also said, we are far, far behind in planning all these things. Now at least we have awakened to see what next we have to do.
All the congratulations to the Empower India Foundation to have produced this report and to express the pledge to fight out the difficulties and deliver what community and nation need.
जो Empower India काम करने जा रही है उसपे मैं बार-बार दूंगा, वो implementation का ऐसा हो, वो उसका हिस्सा, जो असल हिस्सा है, जो दवाई है, वो दवाई implementation की है. आप ये काम करने जा रहे हैं कि मैं अपनी तरफ से एक हिंदुस्तानी मुसलमान एक इकाई होने की हैसियत से एक मामूली फर्द होने की हैसियत से आपका मुबारकबाद देता हूं आपको कि आपने इस अज़्म का इज़हार किया कि आज जब हम 70 साल की आजादी के मना रहे हैं तो आपने ये तय किया कि हम विजन 2047 के ऊपर हम सोचें.
Finally, I would like to also thank all of you for coming together here, because without your presence, this program would not have been a success. So inshallah, let's hope and strive to carry forward the messages that we have received in this program and strive to make this project a success. Thank you.